and welcome to the Politics Pen. My name is Manuela, and I'll be your guide today. The purpose of this video is to take a look at the basic functionalities of our PIM to help you get started. So, let's jump in and take a look.
Politics' PIM gives you a clear and simple overview of all your products and product information. The columns here display what we call attributes, and you can set them up exactly how you like. Customize your table view to make your data more digestible, and only view the information you need without getting bogged down with any of the information you don't. You can choose the attributes you want to add and drag and drop them in the order that makes the most sense to you. When you're finished, just press save. As you can see, the columns have changed and we can save this view to revisit it later.
This way, John and Pili here can each choose their own sets of filters and columns and optimize data simultaneously without interfering with each other's work. Now let's see how you can work with your product data in Politics.
From the table view, you can edit any attribute directly, just like editing cells in a spreadsheet. You can also edit product information in bulk. Just select the SKUs you want to modify and choose the attributes you need to update. And voila! If you want to get a quick glance of the products that need work, you can use a completeness attribute.
Completeness attributes are easy to set up and can be configured for any purpose, like tracking how ready your products are for your website.
Here, we're looking at all of the attributes that are required for my Shopify store. Let's create a dynamic product list, what we call smart lists, so that we can easily view and work with the items we want to sell in Shopify. We can start by filtering to view all of the products that are ready to go, or 100% complete. 29 products, not bad. Let's save this filter so that we can use it later when we're ready to cover how to syndicate products to Shopify and other web shops. But that's for future videos. Now, if I change this filter again to show the products that are less than 100% complete, I get all of the products that still need a bit of work. Essentially, it's my to-do list. As I add data to my products, you'll notice that they disappear from the table view. That's because they're automatically added to the Shopify Ready list that we created and saved earlier. Pretty neat, huh? If you want to update your product information on a product level, simply click the product SKU and the product detail page will open, displaying all of the information or attributes for that product. Here, we can easily navigate to the Asset tab to get an overview of all the assets or digital files that are linked to this product.
With Politics, there are no limitations when it comes to your assets, so you can upload as many as you like without worrying about size or type. You can store your product images, videos, graphics, and even instruction manuals right where they belong, with your products.
Next, let's jump to the Variations tab. This helps organizing internally and makes the customer experience on your website easier. Here, you can easily link products based on their variations, like size or color. So for example, here you can see this bag comes in 6 different colors. Similar to variations, you can also set up relationships between your products from the Relationships tab. Like in this example, we can see that these boots are a popular purchase along with this snowboard and the perfect fit for these bindings. And there we have it, your introduction to the fundamentals of the Politics PIM, the fast and easy way to work on your product data.
I hope you enjoyed this tour. And after watching this video, I think you're ready to explore the PIM all on your own. There's still lots more to learn, but we'll get to that in future videos. Thanks for joining me and have a great day.